And our politics lead, concerning new warnings today from experts on extremism who fear the attack on the Capitol and the threats we've seen leading up to inauguration are likely just the beginning. These experts who study groups such as white supremacists say there has been a surge of chatter in fringe online spaces about taking back America, as far-right figures and QAnon conspiracy theorists are joined by Trump supporters who believe falsely that the election was stolen. In order to understand the threat of this big lie, CNN's Sarah Seidner, who covers hate groups for CNN, talked to some of the extremists pushing the big lie, and she filed this report to highlight the danger in our midst.
The conspiracy-fueled deadly Capitol attack on January 6th may be just the beginning of an explosion of far-right violence.
The plots of tomorrow, the activities of tomorrow, the efforts for them to maintain this movement and create threats in the future are literally being planned today.
Far-right radicalization has been building in America for years, evidence of it all over the largest social media platforms on Earth. And even after megasites like Facebook said they were cracking down, the Tech Transparency Project, a nonprofit watchdog group, found it's still easy to find extremist content calling for violence on the site. 3 days after the attack, this post: "We need to organize our militia. Wars are won with guns, and when they silence your commander-in-chief, you are in a war." Another posted January 14th. "Patriots, January 20th, 2021 is your Tiananmen Square moment."
Social media to extremism is like oxygen for fire. It's required. It has shown itself to be one of the organizing factors for extremists.
Facebook removed the post from the site and the public group calling itself the Patriot Party, but the poison has already set in. In Michigan, after an armed rally at the Capitol against the governor last year, federal and state authorities thwarted an alleged violent plot to kidnap the governor. A few of the same men who say they stood by some of those alleged plotters returned yesterday. And as with the Capitol Hill terrorists, these guys are out in the open, sharing their extreme views.
And tell me about your patch.
Patch? This one? This is a boogaloo?
We do not want a civil war or anything. We want to exercise every possible way before that comes an option.
Is that an option in your mind, a civil war?
I will not fire the first shot. But if it comes to that, I will fight.
The Boogaloo Boys are a burgeoning anti-government group which started online. Some of its members are pushing for civil war. At least one Michigan Boogaloo boy was arrested this fall in the plot to kidnap the governor. A plan for violence that law enforcement thankfully prevented, and yet those who support the plan are all right out in the open.
Would you have supported them if they had kidnapped the governor?
I would have supported a citizen's arrest on a felony, because that is what the law states. If a felony is committed, a citizen can arrest another citizen.
The governor has not committed a crime, but instead was a potential victim of a violent crime. And yet, the lie persists among extremists, threatening Michigan legislators' safety. They brought their weapons. They do have the right to open carry, but some see their firearms as clear threats. This guy said he does not support violence and would only use his AR-15 to save an innocent life.
So that's the weapons you hear a lot of times that are used in attacks that are not to save innocent people.
Yeah.
Why carry it? I mean, have you been in the armed forces?
I was in the National Guard, yes. This right here is not dangerous unless the person behind it is dangerous. I would say that this ain't any different than the muskets the Minutemen carried back in the Revolution.
While he stood outside the Capitol, current National Guardsmen stood nearby at the ready to protect Michigan's seat of government, much like Guardsmen are doing across the country in case the next wave of violence erupts.
And we should be clear on a couple of things. A musket, by the way, could fire like one or two rounds in a minute. The weapon he has could fire about 45 rounds in a minute. And going further, we should mention this as well, that the National Guard in Washington, D.C. is actually being vetted very closely, just in case there's anyone within that group that has extremist ideas. Jake?
Yeah, that's not a Minuteman. That's an extremist. Sarah Seidner, thanks so much. Appreciate it. You might remember there were some Georgia Republicans back in December warning that all these lies the president was telling could be dangerous.
Someone's going to get hurt. Someone's going to get shot. Someone's going to get killed. and it's not right.
That was Gabriel Sterling. Another one of those truth tellers who ended up being attacked by President Trump is the Republican Lieutenant Governor of Georgia, Jeff Duncan, who joins me now. And you were warning back then, too, is what happened on January 6th at the Capitol, is that what you and Gabe Sterling and others were worried about?
Well, Jake, actions have consequences, and unfortunately, we're watching those consequences play out. January 6th was certainly some of those consequences. When you're willing to lie to 350 million Americans for two straight months, stuff like this is going to happen. And it's unfortunate, and I cannot wait for us to continue to move forward. Let's get Wednesday behind us and move on as a country.
I wish it were that easy, but, you know, you just saw Sarah's reporting. These experts on extremism tell CNN it's not just white supremacists and QAnon members behind this growing number of violent threats. They're being joined by these fierce Trump supporters who believe falsely that the election was stolen from them. How much blame do you think Donald Trump and those who supported this lie, including the outgoing senators, Loeffler and Perdue, how much blame do you put on them?
Well, I'm still astonished at the amount of misinformation that continues to fly in and folks just being misinformed to complete conspiracy theories. But I will tell you that it's in the process of slowing down that chatter, but it's still with us. And certainly this is going to be a pivot point for us to move forward. The tragic events on the 6th were awful, but I truly see it as a catalyst moment for this party to move on to better and brighter days. And I've said this before, Jake, we let ourselves put a person in front of the party, and that, I assure you, should never happen again in the Republican Party.
You know, from your mouth to God's ears, sir, but, you know, in a new CNN poll, it's very clear that only 19% of Republicans say that Joe Biden legitimately won enough votes to win the presidency. 75% of Republican voters falsely believe he did not. How do you fix that when a majority of your party, not just people in Congress, but rank and file, just normal citizens, believe these lies, and there are so many members of your party who are spouting them, including elected officials?
Certainly, we've got a lot of work in front of us. You've heard me talk about this before, GOP 2.0. We're actually starting the wheels in motion and got an exploratory committee together, not to create a new party, but and not to try to, you know, reinvent the wheel, but to reform and start to heal the party through reminding folks of the policies and reminding ourselves of the policies that make us Republicans. Community outreach, tone and messaging that rivals Ronald Reagan and not Donald Trump's messaging patterns for the last 4 years. We got our work cut out for us, but look, there's brighter days ahead and more civil days ahead for the Republican Party. I can assure you of that.
I know that you're making an effort to do this. You stripped of their committee chairmanships or memberships in key committees three Republican lawmakers in Georgia who supported these lies about election fraud. But what about here in Washington, D.C.? You have House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, House Minority Whip Steve Scalise. They both pushed these lies, pushed them. Rona McDaniel, the chair of the RNC, Twitter account was not just pushing lies, they were pushing out the craziest stuff. Sidney Powell, that lawyer who just espoused all this lunacy, saying that Trump won in a landslide. How can your party move forward when these people are leading your party nationally?
Well, certainly, like I said, we've got a lot of work in front of us, but, you know, I think it comes on focus. The focus has got to be on reaching in to the communities that we, you know, Jake, we talked about this before on the policy side. You know, Build the Wall was a project name. It was not an immigration reform. When we talk about health care, we can't just scream about Obamacare. We've got to work with folks. We've got to have big ideas. We got to move away from these folks that the misinformation was a short-term sugar high. And we need to focus long-term. I'm selfishly focused on long-term because I've got three young kids. I want to hand off a party in a country that's you know, admirable.